Welcome back to The Grind. I wanted to make another brief video to discuss my final thoughts and opinions on Noctarn versus FafNyr and share a little bit more of my thoughts that I've been having recently, a little bit of additional information that I haven't really discussed in previous videos. Most of my thoughts and recommendations are the same as in my last video, where I go through the spell details after the updates of both of the dragons and discuss which players I think would benefit from which dragons. But I'm going to go a little bit further in this video, so go back and watch this video if you haven't seen it, or if you need a refresher, if you need help deciding which dragon you're going to pick. So for me, I've decided to get Noctarn because I think that I'll have more fun with him and I can make more videos with him. The reason that I'm kind of between the two is I don't think either is perfect for me, and we'll get into that in a little bit. First, I want to compare which one is stronger. I think for sure Noctarn is a stronger dragon if you can fly him well, and particularly, which we'll go into more details shortly, at higher tiers, he is more beneficial. Now, FafNyr is a little bit easier to fly, so with a little bit less effort and skill, you can fly him pretty well and you can destroy some pretty decent bases. Noctarn, however, is a lot more challenging to fly well, so he doesn't actually become better than FafNyr until you've actually started to practice and become better at flying Noctarn, at which point his potential strength and his ability to destroy stronger bases then exceeds FafNyr's ability. So if you like a challenge, Noctarn will be great. If you need someone who you can consistently fly against certain average bases or a reliable dragon against equal tiered with defenders, then FafNyr might be a safer option. Now, the other issue that I'm having, and this is mainly why I think Noctarn is not ideal for me, is because Noctarn is built to fight equal tier bases. He can't really hit up tiers that well, and if he is trying to, he won't be able to destroy the towers, and he probably will struggle to set up the whole base. Now, there are several dragons who can set up maxed bases and do quite well. If you learn to fly Hasset, for example, he can actually 70% a lot of maxed bases and set it up to be cleared by the following dragon. Noctarn, this would be very challenging and very rage costly, and I don't think that I would ever get to the point where I would use him in that manner. So for me, I won't be able to use him very well as a setup dragon, and I won't be able to use him well as a 100% base is stronger than I'm destroying already, and I won't be able to use him as a speed attacker. So really, I don't get a whole lot of benefit from him except the fun and enjoyment from flying him and making videos to share with people. Now, he will be useful for war runs and attacks and for maybe following other players, but at an earlier tier, he doesn't really give the benefit that a lot of players will get from him at maxed tier. So if they're only attacking bases at equal tier, then Noctarn is a really solid dragon because he is built to destroy those towers and to survive a couple shots. Whereas for me, I will not be able to take any shots if I'm attacking towers that are a few tiers above my tier. Now, if you are at endgame, Noctarn will be great for you, especially if you put in a little of the effort. If you are a low skill flyer, then at endgame, I think Noctarn will be better than FafNyr still. If you're a high skill flyer, he'll be much better. And even in mid tiers, I think you'll probably get more benefit from Noctarn. Now, FafNyr is a pretty solid, reliable dragon, and I think can be used quite effectively by lower tier players because FafNyr is able to destroy max level towers with guild. So even if you're following a high level player on your team, you can help and you can destroy some really strong towers or clean up the farms and mills. So even for a low level player, FafNyr can be very beneficial because it allows you to follow and help out your higher level teams. So this can be very beneficial in wars as a cleanup dragon. So a low-level player will get a lot more benefit from FafNyr than Noctarn, potentially. At higher levels, FafNyr, I don't think, will be able to keep up with the higher-level towers, especially defended. And this has been a lot of what I've heard from players who have gotten FafNyr or have watched FafNyr flying against bases, where at higher levels, higher tiers, FafNyr just cannot hold up and will not be able to destroy bases, especially if they're defended. While Noctarn, if you fly him well, has that potential. Now, this information is not meant to make you change your mind on which dragon you're going to get. It's really meant to help those who are not fully decided or just needed one more pro or one more con to help them make their decision. So for me, neither of these dragons is really a must have. I don't need a cleanup dragon for Fafnir. I don't really need a lead setup dragon, a lead or setup dragon, because I have better lead and setup dragons for the position I am in. Because I am not end game, Noctarn doesn't have the same potential to destroy bases as other dragons that I already have who can hit bases several tiers up, even with defenders. So then it just comes down to which one would I rather have and which one would I enjoy flying more. And if you know me at all, usually the answer is going to be Hunters. So I'm going to get Noctarn. I'm going to enjoy flying him and playing around with him and making videos flying her. Oh my goodness, I've done it again. This whole video I've been saying him, flying her. I apologize to all of you out there who keep correcting me on this. I just can't seem to get it right. But regardless, I hope this helped somebody anyways in making their decision or in understanding the difference between these dragons a little bit more. There really is no definitive one answer for every person. It really depends on each player's position and play styles. So I hope this helped. Good luck in the remainder of this season and good luck learning to fly your new dragons. See you in the next video.